So we just finished doing our setup, and you didn't see all the activity behind the scenes. It's essentially building a city out here in the middle of an open lot. And we're happy to be here because this is the lot where back in 2010, 2011, we had our biggest crowds. So it can hold upwards of 50,000 people over the three-day event.
Can you give us a quick rundown of what people can expect to find?
Sure. So, of course, the first thing is our main stage, which is sponsored by Imagine Theater. And so we have 3 days of great entertainment. It's local. It's a lot of it is from grade school to high school to local and regional talent that come here and play.
Right behind us is Grace Elizabeth Lee. She's a 17-year-old singer-songwriter from the Rochester area, but becoming nationally known. She's fabulous. So we have people on our stage all night long. Leah Catello coming up, and our headliner, Steve Taylor, and then all kinds of acts all weekend long.
Then we have our Connect Cafe, which is where we have a lot of presenters that bring information, again, about healthy living, products, body condition, how to live healthier, how to treat things naturally and holistically. And a lot of people come out for that. That's a lot of interest right there for that. But on top of that, we have over 100 exhibitors here.
We are By the Change. We're a Michigan-based social enterprise focused on empowering women in the developing world. Everything that you see here was handmade by a woman living somewhere in a country where most people are living on less than $2 a day. We are focused on helping women build businesses in places where it's nearly impossible to do that. Today we thought we were a fit for this show because a lot of the things that we have are made from recycled materials.
Can you talk to us about some of the specific pieces you have here?
We have a lot of products called Cantha, and Cantha is hand-stitched recycled sari fabrics. And because they use everything, when it can't be a dress anymore, then they make other things out of it. And it's something that they have all learned to do, all the women, from their mothers and their grandmothers. So in addition to everything else, we're keeping traditional craft alive. And every piece has a story, and for me, has a woman and a face and a family behind it. It's not just a bag. One of my favorite things about this whole process is as I've traveled, and I go and I see that a lot of the daughters of the women that we work with are in school because their moms are earning the money to pay for it. And then I know that we're creating generational change on top of just putting food on the family's table.
Okay, Rhea, tell us what's happening in your tent today.
Well, here at the tent, we have a trunk show going on for our store, Loli, and we have featured our recyclable, eco-friendly materials in honor of Earth Day. So we have our eco-friendly yoga mat. We have a couple of eco-friendly leggings out here, too. These ones right here are specifically made out of organic cotton, and then these pants over here are made out of recycled plastic bottles.
Why do you think it's important to use recycled materials in your products?
Definitely, just do we want to show that we love our earth, we love our community, and by using eco-friendly materials in our products, it just shows that we care for the environment too. I mean, yoga, you deal with the calmness and the serenity and just being at peace with yourself and the environment, and with Earth Day too, we want to celebrate the earth. We want to celebrate everything that we love about the earth, and I feel that the balance of harmony with yoginis and Earth Day just all meshes together.
John Batdorf was one of the original founders of the event back 12 years ago. When I first came on, I was actually working for a company that exhibited here, and it was my introduction to the event, and I was just amazed at the crowd that came out, the companies that were here, the excitement that was here. The next year, I just really felt compelled to come back here, so I contacted John and said, how do I participate? And so he invited me to go to the Michigan Green Team website and sign up as a volunteer. And so there was young people that had come out, there was corporate groups that were looking for community events, and just a lot of individuals that liked this type of event program, they would come out and work with us.
Well, you mentioned that Rochester's been doing this for 12 years, and this is your sixth year. How have you seen the event change over that time?
Our event has grown quite a bit. Not only our exhibitors, but now we have these fabulous food trucks, which we didn't have when I first started.
Okay, Karen, you're hard at work today. Can you tell us what you've been up to?
Well, we're making a lot of vegan sandwiches and soups and salads.
What is vegan cuisine?
It is using vegetables and plant-based materials to make a very delicious meal.
What's the relationship between the Earth Day Fest and veganism?
It is the environmental impact that vegan food has. When you eat meat, you are robbing the earth of a lot of resources between water and the food that you use to feed the animals. We have plenty of food that is very tasty that we can do with way less resources, way less money, feed more people, and be kinder on the environment, and especially to animals.
Okay, Deanne, can you tell us about your tent today?
Yes, this is a tent for Straw Bale Studio, which is a place and also a program that has straw bale homes with thatched roofs. And there's activities there, classes, and full moon potluck, and people can tour with an appointment. And it's an opportunity to explore working directly with nature, unmediated by machines, pretty much, which is a passion of mine to reconnect people in nature. Over time, our materials became less and less local, you know, as we were able to transport things in. And we started to design homes where we design what we wanted, and then we go out to the whole world to figure out where to get it. And as we know, some of the products are made in a factory and may not be healthy. And so now there's a movement, a natural building movement around the world, and people are building super insulated homes from local materials, the straw bales, covering them with local dirt. And the one at Straw Bale Studio is 18 years old now. It's expected to go maybe another 20. And then it's biodegradable and beautiful.
What is the importance of celebrating Earth Day?
Oh, it's everything to me. You know, if we don't have a planet, we don't have anything. And I love to travel, and I love to know about cultures. And it's really important for all of us to speak out and, you know, asking where the things that we buy came from, asking how everything that we do affects the planet and affects everyone else. Really important, too.
I feel like we're parts of a larger body. And so to feel really connected to the Earth and to become just more and more aware of what ways we support life or what ways we don't support life, and, you know, make those choices very consciously, is a joyful thing and an important thing.
I think we become very into our lives and into our own individual worlds that we don't take that time to recognize what a difference a single person can make on the environment. And those little things that you can do, whether it be taking a shorter shower, doing recycling, those little things add up.
Definitely come on down and check out what we have. There's local businesses here. It's a great way to even just get out and get active too, to enjoy Earth Day, enjoy the festivities.
You know, if you aren't sure how to learn about alternative medicines, alternative therapies, if you want to learn more about services and products that can help you be healthier emotionally, physically, as well as, again, a more healthy home, this is the place you want to be.
Community activism is what Earth Day was originally all about. And that's what we're trying to bring that message back. So especially on a local level, we need to be involved in our own communities, in our own lives, in our environment, and all be aware of what we need to do to keep it clean and healthy so that we can live and benefit from the triple bottom line, as they call it. And it's people, planet, prosperity. And all three of those things come together at an event like this. You can't find this information elsewhere.